Got a few minutes here, so I thought I'd film on the fly. This is still the dresser. Sadly, it's taken me over a week to get back to it. But I wanted to just kind of show you the next step before I got too far along. So here we go. Since we've last seen each other, I've splotchy applied different colors of the Debbie's Design Diary DIY paint. So we've got faded burlap, we've got beadboard, we've got a little black dress, we've got all kinds of colors underneath. And I apologize that I didn't think to take at least stills to show you what that looked like, but it was pretty ugly. So now I am taking the letterpress gray and I've painted over all of it. And I'm taking our new misters, and these are now available too, and these are wonderful. And Kelly C. Glass, you are correct. Mister versus spray bottle really is a game changer. So I'm going back through, and I'm misting the surface. And the only putty knife I have at the moment is plastic, which is not ideal. So I have nothing but the finest tools here at the Painted Mermaid. So I've got my butter knife, which I really like as well. And I'm going back through, and after I am misting and reactivating, I am scraping up. So now, for those of you who are diehard Don't Paint the Wood fans, let me reassure you that in this particular case, it's a really nicely made dresser, but it's made with scrap wood. So we've got different kinds of wood in here, and the top actually has kind of a laminated surface. So gasp, we are painting laminate, but with the mineral paints, you don't have to sand, you don't have to prime. Once you get it on here and you top coat it either with the big top or the wax or the various other goodies that come in this are available through this collection, it's sealed and it's good to go. I promise. I mean, you do not have to do a chippy look. That's the question that I frequently get. Does it have to be chippy? I just want a solid surface. Of course, you can just do a solid surface, but I want to be an artist when I grow up in me likes to do this. So I've just moistened the paint, and I'm just going back through and scraping some of it up. Now, again, we're emulating been in the barn or, been beaten up in the attic kind of look here. So we're scratching it back, making sure it's nice and wet. And I did let this guy sit for over a week, which is fine, but it would have been a little easier to play with had I done it sooner in the process. But some of y'all know I've been on the road. And going back out on Thursday, by the way. So anyway, I'm just kind of scraping up and smooching back down. That is the technical term, ladies and gentlemen, smooching back down. And whoops, make sure your water's going in the right direction. And then just revisiting the, getting the moisture back on it and just doing it kind of randomly. So I don't want it to come off the surface everywhere. But I do like to be able to see just a little bit of the wood, or in this case, a faux wood, peeking through. So I'm going to play with this. I'm going to smoosh it around. I'm going to get it, consistent in that the whole piece will show some wear. But, the worst thing you can do, in my opinion, when you're doing a worn or primitive type look, the worst thing you can do is make it too consistent, because then it really does look like, a made in China version of this. So I'm going to play with this. Once it sets up, I'll try to regroup with you, and we'll whip out the sander and go from there. All right. Thanks, guys. Have a good afternoon. See you when you get here.